leads on to idea number three. The third lesson you're learning in business is super important. I've kind of covered it when I discussed two, but this is very important. Start ideas for free. People come to me all the time, Andrew, I have an idea for a business. Maybe you need a small investment. It's normal. Let's say you're developing an app, you need to invest in the app or something. That happens. But a lot of people ask for insane amounts of money. 50 grand, 100 grand, 200 grand, oh, to start my business. You can start businesses very, very cheaply if you do it the right way. Let's look at our beautiful demonstration, our beautiful diagram here of our makeup company. If you start a makeup company this way, you need minimum 200 grand. You need an office, you need logos, you need trademarks, you need stock, you need staff, you need company incorporation, you need tax, you need accountants, you need advertising budgets. You need 200 grand, 200K to start this business. If you start business this way, make a website, put some pictures on there, pretend you've got a whole bunch of stuff you ain't got and start getting money in, you can start this business for 5 grand, let's say for the website, 5 grand. That's 195 grand difference. Now, the problem with this business is you're gonna start getting money in and you're not gonna have any way to fulfill the orders. But back to business lesson number one, because you're a fast worker, because you're industrious, because you work with speed, you'll find a way to fulfill the orders. Hey, listen, worst case, you give them the money back. Worst case, you refund them. But at least with this idea, you can test the viability of your plan, one. And two, you're not in the hole. So let's assume both companies are bound to fail. Here you've lost 5 grand. Here you've lost 200 grand. Why risk all that money when you can do it cheap? Also, with 5 grand startups, you can now, for the same price as starting one company, you can now start 40 companies. One of them's gonna work because they're 5 grand each to start. One of them's gonna work. So you have to learn that the idea of starting a business is not expensive. Get that out of your head. I'm a millionaire, a multimillionaire, and I will not spend more than 5 grand launching a company. 5 grand max. I'll spend 5 grand, and if I see money coming in, maybe I'll invest some more. Or when the money starts coming into the makeup company, you might reinvest all the money. That's fine, because that ain't your money. That's money you're making. You can build a company off the money you're bringing in from the company and never spend your own money. That's how you launch a company. Now, every time I say this, people go to me, oh, well, what about this? What about that? If you're gonna launch a fucking airplane company and try and compete with Boeing, you need money, obviously. But I'm talking about for you guys out there, this is the Hustlers University. If you're looking at making money, starting a new company, or you already have a small company, some of the biggest mistakes you can make is investing lots of money. When you're broke, it's hard to make mistakes because you don't have any money to lose. When you're rich, it's easy to make mistakes because you have a lot of money to lose. Start companies as cheaply as possible, basically for free, by prioritizing money in and not prioritizing fulfillment. That way, you get to start companies cheap. You can start a lot of them. You have money coming in the door and you can reinvest money you're making in your company and build your company from the ground up. Every company I ever made, including T2 Television, was done this way. When I got my first deal for T2 Television, I had a BlackBerry and a business card. And I went to their office and I signed the deal. I had a business bank account that was free. No tax incorporation, nothing. They paid me and I used that money to buy an office. Done. I started a television advertising agency like this. I didn't get an office first. Office, staff, computers, desks. I didn't have any money. I had the 12 grand from the commission, but I was saving that for myself in case it all went wrong. I could have blown my whole 12 grand and set up the office. But no, I bought a laptop. I had a laptop. I bought a BlackBerry, had a business card, landed my first deal, and set up my whole business off of money already coming in. And if you can do that with an advertising agency, you can do that with nearly anything. This is television advertising. This is like premier shit back in 13, 14 years ago, before the internet was big almost. Everyone wanted to be on TV. That's how you start companies. I started an advertising company with a fucking BlackBerry. This is how. This allows you to start more businesses and allows you to see what's viable and what's gonna make money and what isn't without risk. It's extremely important you approach businesses this way and not businesses this way. It is extremely important. Get this in your head. These first three lessons about speed, about money in being priority over everything else, and about starting businesses with this focus as opposed to the cost focus, money in as opposed to fulfillment. That's good. That, I've already taught you more than you're going to learn about business anywhere else. That's key. Because if you do things this way, it's very hard to have a monumental fuck up. It's very hard to lose money. And also, now you can start nearly any company. You can start nearly any business. Give me a business. Name something completely random.
A record label.
A record label. You want to start a record label. So, record label, what do you have? You have, this is completely on the fly. Record label. So, let me wipe my board. This is completely on the fly, unprompted. We're testing my business genius for the Hustlers University. Let me clear my beautiful diagram here. Right, so how does a record label make money? Make. We have make and we have costs. So a record label makes money by selling records, correct? I've never run a record label, so I might be wrong. So you have to sell records. Now, a record label is a digital product, so it's actually harder than makeup, because how can you sell records you don't have? So what I'd be looking to do first thing is test my distribution channels. So costs, you need to find records you can instantly supply, unlike a makeup company. So you need to find artists which are, I wouldn't say struggling, but there's certainly, you need to go out there and find some artists which don't want money up front. So you need to work out some kind of commission deal with artists and say, look, we're gonna give you X amount on the basis of the sales. So you have to find, we're gonna put broke boys. Because it doesn't, you know what? At this point, especially with a record label, although you need good quality artists to have a good reputation as a record label, if you have shit ones at the beginning, it doesn't really matter. If you have some shit ones and you sign Rihanna later on, is it going to be like, oh, they have Rihanna now, but 3 years ago they had that crap band no one's heard of. They ain't going to care. It's not going to damage your reputation. So at this point, you can just get broke boys. Get broke boys, offer them a commission deal to make just to try and sell records. So let's say we're selling a record for a pound. Let's say it's a 50-50 split, 50-50. Now you've got distribution channels. How are you going to sell the records? Where are you going to sell them? Apple Music, Spotify, whatever. You have to test the distribution channels, test them out. Test out an independent distribution channel. So let's say you do all the traditional distribution, traditional stuff. And let's say you want to try and sell some stuff independently. So let's say you start a website or you go on, is MySpace still even a thing for music?
No, what's the other one? SoundCloud or something like that.
Yeah, so there's a few other abstract ways you can try and sell money. You can try and sell records. Let's say through their own website or through SoundCloud, through some of the other ones. You can try some abstract methods. Now here's what I would do. I'm running a record label. I find broke boys. Broke boys agree to go a 50-50 split. I promise to sell loads of records. You have to promise. This is your job. So I promise to sell fucking 100,000 records a month. Some bullshit. I promise. I'd lie. This is what I do all the time. No big deal. 100,000 a month. Easy, easy, easy. I'd get them. I'd put them across all the distribution channels. I'd see how many we sell. If we don't sell any, do you know whose fault it is? The broke boy's fault. I'll come back to them and go, okay, well, yeah, we have two of your songs. It's not enough. People don't know who you are. We need to produce some content to raise your profile. I don't know if you guys have any videos of you performing live. We need more music we can put out there. Da, da, da. And I would just continue to extract from the broke boys more videos, more songs, all for free, all based on a commission deal, and just put it out there. Speed, just like we said in number one. Like I said, I've never run a record label in my life. This has come off the top of my head. Speed. Give me more, give me more, give me more. The more they produce, the more they give you, and the more you put out there, it doesn't matter. If you sell a little bit of each, you're gonna start to make money. Look at what we do and what I do, all my different businesses. At this moment, I run CobraTech.com. I have the War Room, which is a business in itself. I have the webcam business. I have two YouTube channels. I have casinos. All I do, because it's just speed, scattergun. So in this kind of particular, if you're gonna do a record label, you need to have as much as possible video and music that you can afford. And when I say afford, a commission only deal, just constantly, constantly put out there speed on every single possible distribution channel. That's what you need to do. Then what you do is, when you have these boys everywhere, broke boys, the broke boy record band, you have them everywhere and you have tons of their stuff, then you can approach someone who's not shit or a little bit better. So we have the less broke boys. Less broke, well, right here. My terrible writing, because I'm writing at an angle. And when you go to less broke boys, you can say, well, look at the broke boys. We've got them on Spotify, SoundCloud. They're on their own website selling. They're here, they're on iTunes, they're there. Look at this, is some videos of them performing. Yeah, we use these for promotion. They're on this YouTube channel, they're on that YouTube channel. The Let's Broke Boys were like, oh, these guys, they actually got them a lot of promo. What did you really do? All you did was extract it from these guys. Now the Let's Broke Boys might want to work with you. Maybe you don't give them, maybe it's a slightly better commission deal. Maybe they get 60, you get 40. Take their shit. Before you know it, you're gonna have a catalog of stuff. So people go, who's this record label? You go, well, bang. And you type any of those bands in and they flood the internet with things. Now you're a real record label. Now new bands, up and coming bands wanna work with you. Just because the amount of promo you got, you put them everywhere. One of these up and coming bands might be the next big thing, who knows? All I've done in this business model, I don't know anything about record labels. All I've done is stick to my tenets of business. One, this is free. This is free. This is running a record label from your bedroom. Doing all this is some work on your computer, putting them on iTunes and making a website, whatever, whatever. That's all fucking free. Negotiate with the broke boys, you can do it at a Costa Coffee or a Starbucks. So that this is a free business I've just given you. One, it's free. Two, we've prioritized money in. The first thing I wrote is how do we make the money? How do we make the money? We sell records. Okay, so we need this, we need this, we need this. Prioritize making the money. And the third thing I did was speed, quickly. Get out, get out, get out. Tell the broke boys to make more. Tell the broke boys to start a daily vlog of them recording, a daily vlog of what it's like in the band. Start putting out on a YouTube channel. Speed, 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 more, more, more. Give me content, content, nonstop, speed. All I did was stick to my three basic business principles. Now, imagine you try this for 6 months and it doesn't work. Have you lost money? No. What did you lose? You didn't have a big fancy office. You didn't lose nothing. What's the worst that can happen? What's the worst that can happen? Nothing. And that is the exact point I'm trying to teach here. If you stick to these three tenets in nearly any business, you'll launch it for basically nothing, and nothing can go wrong. Nothing can go wrong.